So good morning guys. I hope you guys have been safe in the home this time. So for this pandemic period, our classes will be going through for the online mode. I hope you guys enjoy the sessions. And I hope you guys be in the home and be safe, okay? Clear? Okay. So for previous sessions, we finished the first lesson, electrostatics. So for first lesson, what is electrostatics? What is electrostatics? Electrostatics is a branch of physics. What is that? Electrostatics is a branch of physics which deals with the study of property of charges in the state of resistance. From this electrostatic, we see that electric field due to electric field we find out. Then we learn electric potential. From the electric potential, we learn the Gauss law. Then Gauss law to capacitors. Then capacitors. Then we learn at last we learn the magnetic of generator. Isn't it? So I hope you guys finish all the lessons, questions, and you write in the notes, isn't it? Okay. So today's sessions we are going to see about the second lesson, current electricity. What is that? Current electricity. So today's sessions we are going to see about the second lesson, current electricity. Okay. Clear. So for first lesson already we learned this, right? So first lesson we learn electrostatics, isn't it? So already we know the electrostatics. Electrostatics means the study of it's a branch of physics which deals with the study of charge surface, isn't it? So the electrostatics, what is that? Electrostatics is a branch of physics. What is that? It's a branch of physics which deals with the study of charges at the rest. But actually we take a copper material, or we take a material means in which they are having a large number of free electrons, isn't it? The free electrons means they are randomly moving in a different directions. So we know that the electrons are randomly moving, or the charges are randomly moving in that different direction means it is important to analyze. What is that? It is important to analyze the behavior of charges. What is that? It is important to analyze the behavior of charges when they are in motion. Okay, so we know that when the electrons are in motion, so this one, the electrons are, because we take a material, so we take a conductor, means if we take a conductor means the conductors having the large number of free electrons, isn't it? What is that? The conductors, they having a large number of free electrons. If they having a free electrons, means they are randomly moving, or the charges will be randomly moving in all directions. So it is important to analyze the behavior of charges. What is that? It is important to analyze the behavior of charges when they are in random motions. Okay? When they are in random motion. So the flow of charges, what is that? The flow of charges which constitute electric current. What is that? The flow of charges which constitute electric current. So the study of flow of charges, what is that? The study of flow of charges, what is that? The study of flow of charges is called as that. Current electricity. So what is the current electricity? The study of flow of charges is called as current electricity. It was known by Alexander Volta. What is that? It was known by Alexander Volta. He was the one who invented electrical battery. Electrical battery means it is used to supply the steady flow of charges. Okay, already we know that water application, now our water battery depends upon the electricity, isn't it? Also, many of applications like a mobile phone, computer, laptops, even the household applications, they are depend upon the electricity, isn't it? So, what's the purpose here? Already for first lessons, we learned that electrostatics, which means the study of charges at the rest. But when we are moving practically, we take conductors or we take a materials like a copper. The copper having the large number of free electrons, isn't it? So free electrons means negative charges. They are randomly moving in all directions. So if they are more randomly moving in all directions means, so we have to, because the first lesson we say the charge is in the state of rest, isn't it? But when we closely moving towards the material, the charges are randomly moving in all directions. So it is important to analyze the behavior of charges when they are moving or when they are in motion. What is that? It is important to analyze the behavior of charges when they are in motion. When they are in motion. So the flow of charges, what is that? The flow of charges which constitute electric current, okay? What is that? The flow of charges which constitute electric current. The current electricity is a branch of physics which deals with the study of flow of charges. So what is the current electricity? Current electricity is a branch of physics which deals with the study of flow of charges. It was first owed by, or it was first explained by Alexander Volt. He was the one who invented electrical battery. Electrical battery which is used to supply the steady flow of charges. Okay. Nowadays the many applications are the modern method we depend on the current electricity or electricity because most of our applications are like from fan, mobile phone, laptop, computer, household applications, they depend upon the electricity, isn't it? Isn't it? Clear? Clear. So I hope you understand the introduction part of clear. So now we are going to see the electrical current. Okay. What is the electric current? So guys, what is the current electricity? So the first lesson, electrostatics. What is electrostatics? The study of branch of physics which deals with the, or is a branch of physics which deals with the study of charges in the state of rest. So what is the current electricity? The current electricity is a branch of physics which deals with the study of flowing charges. The study of flowing charges. Okay? Clear? Clear. So, next we are going to see the electric current. As we know that the materials which is made up of are the matters which is made up of large number of atoms. Any matters, okay, or any material they are made up of large number of atoms. Guys, the atoms means the atoms consist of a positive charge nucleus and the negative charge electrons are revolving around the positive charge nucleus. So the matters are material made up of large number of atoms. The atom consists of a positive charge nucleus at the center and the negative charge electrons are revolving around the nucleus. In which the sum of a free electron, the sum of electrons which is loosely attached to the nucleus. What is that? The sum of electrons which are loosely attached to the electrons. So they can be freely moved towards the surface. Or they can be freely moved towards the towards any material. So these electrons are called as free electrons. So the electrons which is loosely attached to the nucleus. The electrons which is loosely attached to the nucleus, the electrons are called as free electrons. They called as free electrons. So we take a matters or any material. They consist of a large number of atoms. But we know though, atom consists of the positive charge nucleus and the negative charge electrons are revolving around in it. In this, some of the electrons are loosely attached to the electron, so they can be easily detached from it. The electrons are called as free electrons. So the material which consists of a large number of free electrons, the material which consists of free electrons is called as conductors. What is that? The material which consists of the large number of free electrons is called as conductors. Okay, so if you take a conductor means, what is that? If you take a conductor means, the conductor they have in a large number of free electrons. So these free electrons are in random motion because each free electron they are moving in a different directions. So there is no net charge moving towards the end. What is that? There is no net flow of charge. What is that? There is no net transfer charges from one end of a conductor to other end of a conductor. So there will be no current. So what's the point we are saying? If you take a conductor means the conductors they are having a large number of free electrons. These free electrons will be randomly moving in all directions. So there is no net charge flow from one end to other end. Because if it is this electrons will be moved towards this end means opposite the direction of current, charges current will be flow, isn't it? But here, these electrons will be randomly moving in all directions. So there is no transfer or there is will be no flow of charges from one end to other end. So there will be no current. Okay, clear. When a potential difference, what is that? When a potential difference will be applied between the ends. What is that? When the potential difference will be applied between the ends, these electrons are accelerated towards the positive terminal. These electrons will be accelerated towards the positive terminal. So they developing a current. Okay? So they flow current. What is that? So they flow of current. So the electrons will be drifted towards the positive terminal of a battery. So the current will be flowing from positive terminal to negative terminal of a battery. Positive terminal to negative terminal of a battery. Clear? Clear. Clear. So since already we learned for 6th lesson, 11th 6th lesson, in the 11th regard, okay, the mass will be always moving from higher gravitational potential to lower gravitational potential. The mass will be always moving from higher gravitational potential to lower gravitational potential. Similarly, if it is a positive charge, means they are moving from higher electric potential to lower electric potential. Higher electric potential to lower electric potential. But if it is a negative charge, means what is that? If it is a negative charge, means they are moving from low electric potential to what is that? They are moving from low electric potential to high electric potential. Okay, clear? So here, what's the point? We say like that. We take a matter. The matter consists of a large number of atoms. The atom consists of a positive charge nucleus and the electrons will be revolving around it, in which the sum of the electrons will be loosely attached to it and they can be easily detached from the nucleus. The electrons are called as free electrons. The material or the substance which having a large number of free electrons means they call as a conductor. So if you take a conductor, means they have a large number of free electrons. These free electrons will be randomly moving in all directions. These free electrons are randomly moving in all directions. So there will be no net charge flow from what is that? There will be no net charge flow from the one end to other end. So there will be no current. In case if an electric field will be applied between the end, means these electrons are randomly are drifted towards the positive terminal, so the charge will be flowing from one end to other end. So they get the current. So the electric current is defined as what is that? The electric current will be defined as the rate of flow of charges. The rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. What is that? The electric charge will be defined as what is that? Our electric current is defined as what is that? The electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. Okay, so what is the electric current? The electric current is defined as what is that? The electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across the area of a given cross section. Okay, if we assume an area, okay, if Q be the charges flowing towards the area of cross section, means if Q be the charges flowing towards the area of cross section, means then the current I is equal to Q by H. So guys, what is new electric current? The electric current is defined as what is that? The electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. If Q be the charge flowing towards the cross section of area A, means the electric current I is equal to Q by T. But here the flow of charge is not constant. The flow of charge is not constant. So the electric current I is equal to del Q by del G. I is equal to del Q by del G. Del QB means the amount of charge. Del QB the charge flowing through the time interval of del T. The current I is equal to del Q by del G. Del QB the charge flowing in the area of cross section through the time interval del T. Or del QB the charge flowing in the flow, del q be the flow of charges in a given area of time interval, a given time interval del d. So current I is equal to del q by del g. But if you want to measure the instantaneous current, means what is that? If you want to measure the instantaneous current, means the limit tends to zero. So you have to measure the average current. So the limit tends to zero. I is equal to limit del t tends to zero del q by del t. So which is equal to value dq by dt. So if you want to measure the instantaneous current, the flow of charges at the instant of time, the current will be at the instant of time is called as the instantaneous current. So the limit del t tends to zero, we get the value dq by dt. And the unit of current, what is that? The unit of current is ampere. So what's the unit of current? Ampere. So guys, what's the unit of current? Ampere. So 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charges flowing in a 1 second. What is that? Passing through the perpendicular cross sectional area of conductor in 1 second. That's the lesson 1 ampere. So guys, what is the 1 ampere? 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charges passing through the perpendicular conductor in perpendicular area of cross section in 1 second. 1 coulomb of charges in 1 second is called as an ampere. 1 ampere. Clear? Clear. So I hope this one you understand. Shall we go further? So guys, what is the electric current? We take a materials. We take a matter which is made up of large number of atoms. The atom consists of a positive charge nucleus and the negative charge electrons are revolving around it, in which the sum of the electrons will be detached from the nucleus or the freely moved from the nucleus. These electrons are called as free electrons. So material which having a free electrons are called as a conductor. So we take a conductor. The conductor, what is that? We take a conductor. The conductor is having a large number of free electrons. Those free electrons are moving in a random direction. These three electrons are moving in a random direction, so there is a no net charge flow from one end to other end. So there will be no current. But when an electric field will be applied between the ends, these electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal of battery. They drifted towards the positive terminal, so there is a flow of charges across the conductor, so we get the current. So guys, what is the current? The current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. What is my rate of current? The current is defined as, what is that? The current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. So if q be the charge flowing in a given area of cross section, A means the current I is equal to q by t. But the flow of charges will be not constant. Because if it is constant, it's okay. But here the flow of charges will be not constant. So the current I is equal to del q by del t. Here the del q be the current flowing across the conductor in a given time interval del t. In a time interval del t. But if you want to measure the instantaneous current or the current at the instant of time, the del t tends to 0. So I is equal to limit del t tends to 0 del q by del t, which is equal to dq by dt. And the last one, the unit of current. What's the unit of current? Ampere. So the current, if 1 coulomb of charges flowing across the area of cross section in 1 second, or 1 coulomb of charges, 1 coulomb of charges flowing through the given perpendicular area of cross section in 1 second, then it is called as an ampere. Then it is called as an ampere. 1 ampere. Clear? So for this part, you got to mark a question. Define electric current. Define instantaneous current. And the last, you got to mark the question. Define 1 ampere. Define 1 ampere. Clear? Clear. So the next one is the conventional current. So in the conventional current, so the arrowhead, okay, the arrowhead which is used to indicate the direction of current, what is that? The arrowhead which is used to indicate the direction of current in this direction of flow of current. Okay, so the flow of current in the direction, what is that? So here the flow of current in the direction from the positive terminal of battery to the negative terminal of battery. So in this convention, the direction of current from the positive terminal of battery to, okay, the negative terminal of battery, so it's called as a conventional current or simply current. This is in the direction of flow of charges. Is in the direction of flow of charges. Is in the direction of flow of charges. Okay. So the current will be current. So for this sector, the arrowhead, what is that? The arrowhead, which is used to indicate the direction of electric current. What is that? The arrowhead, which is used to indicate the direction of electric current, in which by this convention, the electric current will be passes from, or it will be flowing from the positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. The positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. The positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. So this simply says that what is done? This is called as the conventional current or simply current. It is in the direction of a flow of charges. For positive charge, they will be is in the direction of a flow of charges. They will be direction of flow of charges. But when we take a typical closed circuits, when we take a typical closed circuits, the electrons are moving from what is that? The electrons are moving from the negative terminal of a battery to the positive terminal of a battery. So the current will be flowing from the positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. So for electronegative charge, the direction of a conventional current is in opposite direction. For negative charge, the direction of conventional current is in opposite direction. So the positive charge and the negative charge, the direction of a conventional current is in. For the transfer of positive charge is the same as the transfer of negative charge, but is in the opposite directions. So the transfer of positive charge will be same as the transfer of negative charge, but they are in opposite direction. So guys, simply what is my conventional current? The arrow gun, which is used to gives the direction of a current. So when they are connected in a battery, in which the current will be flowing from the positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. So this is called as a conventional current or simply current, which is same direction of a positive charge, which is having the same direction of positive charge. But when you are taking a typical circuits, they having the electrons will be moving from the negative to the positive terminal, so the current will be flowing from a positive to the negative terminal of a battery. So that by the transfer of positive charge will be same as the transfer of negative charge, but they are in opposite directions. Okay, the direction of a positive charge is same as the transfer of flow of charge. Positive charge will be same as the flow of negative charge, but they are in a opposite direction. They are in a opposite direction. Clear? Clear? Clear. So the next one is a drift velocity. Okay, the next one is a drift velocity. So guys, drift velocity and mobility is one of our important 3-mark questions. Okay, drift velocity. So already we know that we take conductor. The conductor by having a large number of free electrons. So these three electrons are moving in the random directions. So these three electrons are moving in the random direction, in which the number of electrons moving in the upward directions will be equal to the number of electrons moving in the downward directions. So there is no net charge, so there will be no current. So we take conductor. If it is conductor, means they having a large number of free electrons, in which these three electrons will be randomly moving in all directions. So the number of electrons moving in the upward direction are moving to upward directions will be equal to the number of electrons moving in the downward directions. So there is no net charge flowing through a conductor. So there is no current. When an electric field, what is that? When an electric field will be applied between the ends. When an electric field will be applied between the ends. Okay. So there is a force exerted at the point. So these three electrons, what is done? Assuming this is a free electron, these three electrons will be randomly moving in the directions. When an electric field will be applied, these three electrons are moving in a different direction, are moving in a zigzag path and move towards the positive terminal. Or these three electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal in a zigzag path. Because these three electrons are drifted towards, are moving towards the positive terminal in a zigzag path. Okay? While they are drifted towards the positive terminal, they attain the velocity. The velocity is called as a drift velocity. So the drift velocity is the velocity in which the free electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field will be applied. So guys, what is the drift velocity? When an electric field will be applied, they create a potential difference. When they create a potential difference, these three electrons, because when before applying electric field, they are moving in a random direction. But when the electric field will be applied, they create a potential difference. What is that? They create a potential difference. So when they create a potential difference, these three electrons which are drifted towards the positive. So they are moving in a zigzag path. Okay, moving towards the positive terminals. Okay, so the drift velocity is a velocity in which the free electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal. The free electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field will be applied. When an electric field will be applied. So guys, what is the drift velocity? Drift velocity is the velocity is defined as, okay, our drift velocity is defined as in which the free electrons are get drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field will be applied. So tau be the average successive of a collision between time. Tau be the average successive collision with time. So the electric force, F vector is equal to E into E vector. F vector is equal to E into E vector. Okay, clear? Now, guys, what's the formula for force? Guys, what's the formula for force? M into A vector. So if you substitute, means what you get? M into A vector is equal to E into E vector. From this, A vector is equal to E into E vector by M. Assuming this will be equation number 1. Assuming this will be equation number 1. So guys, what's the formula for acceleration? The velocity by time, isn't it? So here, the drift velocity will be v vector. So the acceleration is equal to, what is that? The acceleration is equal to drift velocity by time. From this, velocity is equal to v vector is equal to a vector into tau. So when you substitute the value of a vector, what do you get? The drift velocity v vector is equal to E vector by M into tau. So if you are rearranging the term, so is that if you are rearranging the term, what do you get? The drift velocity v vector is equal to E tau by M into E vector. E tau by M into E vector. Here, E tau by M is equal to, what is that? E tau by M is equal to mobility mu. E tau by M is equal to mobility mu. So if you substitute this, what you get? The drift velocity v d vector is equal to mu into mu vector. Here, what is the mobility? What is that? Mu is defined as that mobility. The mobility means the drift velocity. The drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. The drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. So what is the drift velocity? It's a mobility. The mobility is defined as what is that? The mobility is defined as the drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. The drift velocity acquired per unit electric field, and the unit is a meters per velocity per second. And its unit is the meters per velocity per second. Clear? 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 So guys, simply say, what is the drift velocity? We take conductor. The conductor is having a large number of free electrons. These free electrons are randomly moving in all directions. So the number of electrons moving in upward directions is equal to the number of directions, number of electrons moving in downward directions. Okay? So there will be no net charge will be flowing, so there will be no current. But when an electric field will be applied, what is that? When an electric field will be applied, they create a potential difference across a x. So this electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal in a zigzag path. When the electrons are drifted, they get the velocity. The velocity is called as drift velocity. So the drift velocity is defined as, okay, drift velocity is the velocity or is defined as the electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field will be applied. What is that? The electrons are drifted towards the positive terminal when an electric field will be applied. So the force F vector is equal to E into E vector. But we know the formula for force, isn't it? By Newton's second law of motion, what's the formula for force? M into A vector. So if you substitute this, what do you get? M A vector is equal to E into E vector. A vector is equal to E A vector by M. But we know the formula for acceleration. Guys, what's the formula for acceleration? Velocity by tau. So okay, the velocity is a drift velocity vd vector. So vd vector by tau. Tau is the average surface circulation at time interval tau. So from this vd vector is equal to a into tau. We know the velocity e vector by tau by into tau. We arrange the term e tau by m into e vector. E tau by m, which is called as a mobility. The mobility is defined as a drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. The drift velocity acquired per unit electric field. So vd vector is equal to mu into e vector, and the unit is a meters per volt per second. Okay, clear. And there is a misconception is that the battery is a source of electron, but it is not there. Okay, when the battery will be connected to a circuit, the electrons will be flow from the negative terminal to the positive terminal of a battery. So the current will be flow from positive to the negative terminal of a battery. Okay, and one more thing we are saying, the mobile phone has no charge, isn't it? Don't say that, it happens charging a battery, okay? Clear? So, understand the misconceptions that, so for this questions, what are the parts we say that? The introduction to the current electricity. So, guys, what is my current electricity? The flow and output, the direction of flow of charges. The flow of charges constitute electric current. So, the electric current, the current electricity is defined as, it's a branch of physics which deals with the flow of charges. Then we see the electric current, isn't it? So guys, what's the electric current? The electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charges across a given area of cross section. So I is equal to Q by T. For the, because the flow of charge will be not constant, so the current I is equal to del Q by del G. For the instantaneous current, I is equal to dQ by dG. And we will have 1 ampere, isn't it? The unit of current will be ampere. If 1 coulomb of charge is flowing in a perpendicular area of cross section 1 second, means that's called as a 1 ampere. Then we see the drift velocity and mobility. Guys, what is the drift velocity and mobility? Conventional condition, isn't it? So the arrow weight is used to indicate the direction of a current. When they connected in a circuit, the current will be flowing from the positive terminal of a battery to the negative terminal of a battery. So it's called as a conventional current or simply current. There is in the direction of positive charges. But in a typical circuit, the electrons will be flow from negative terminal of battery to the positive terminal of battery. So the current will be flow from positive to the negative terminal of a battery. So for a negative charge, the conventional current is in opposite charge. So the same number of positive charge will be equal to the transfer of positive charge will be same as the transfer of negative charge, but they are in opposite directions. Next one is the drift velocity and mobility. So guys, what is my drift velocity? Drift velocity is the velocity in which the free electrons get drifted towards the positive terminal. And the expression V vector is equal to U into E vector, and the unit of drift velocity is equal to meter per second. Then mobility. Guys, what is mobility? The drift velocity acquired per unit electric field is called as mobility. E tau by m is equal to u, and the unit is the meters per volt per second. It's one of the important questions distinguished between the drift velocity and mobility. So for this sessions, we learn electric current, instantaneous current, what is conventional current, then explain the drift velocity and mobility. Okay? So I hope you understand the session and you should be learn, okay? Thank you.